Konnichiwa. Welcome to my channel. I'm going to be showing you some very lovely sounding objects. So let us begin and get really nice and relaxed. Just make your shoulders and your neck relaxed. Relax your arms. Relax your hands. Keep your breathing nice and calm and relaxed. Make your legs all relaxed and your feet relaxed. We have here today a very unusual box, some traditional Japanese candies. They were from my friend Tomoko, and we were at art school together. So let me show you. Let me just come around this side to show you. Very cute little box. It has a cream lid and a navy blue bottom section. Now the lid has some writing. Creative looking. Just wonder what it says. But here we have an illustration, and we have two little bunnies. We have one here. And we have one here. And they are both playing in some flower beds. It's a very cute, a very kawaii illustration. Very much. And this must be the artist's signature. Perhaps, I don't know. So, let's delve inside. Unfortunately, I have eaten the candies. They were gorgeous. And the packages within here were so pretty, like little origami packaging with little cornstarch wrapped candies. It's so tasty. So let's open. Now, I do have a personal note from my friend in here. I will tell you what she says about the candies. We have a little bear on here, and he's waving. Hello, Mr. Bear. And we have some very pretty flowers all over the envelope. By the way, her English is very good. And I don't speak a word of Japanese, which is really quite rubbish. I really should learn. Maybe try and write. Okay, so. Right. Here we go. So this is what my friend says. I'm just going to read. I enclose some Japanese traditional confectionery called rakugan, which is a dry confectionery of starch, rice, soybean, barley flour, sugar, and pressed into a pattern. And they're absolutely gorgeous. Just want to show you an illustration from this paper. So cute. So we both went to the same art school in London. And we generally write to each other birthdays and Christmas. They have a little leaflet inside here. And of course, it opens out back to front. We've got some writing. I believe that could that be the illustrator's signature? Just a bit closer. Just a bit closer. There you go. So that's a very gorgeous illustration. A kind of chubby little bunny rabbit. And then we have this mosaic kind of maze with some roses and a petal and some flowers and weeds and some earth. Little bits of maybe plants. So it opens out like this. And from what I can make out, it tells you a little bit about where these confectionery are made. To show you a bit closer. This would be like the molds they're pressed into, and the actual candies look like this. So they look like that. They come inside two little parcels within the box. Very beautiful writing. Then we have a picture. I'm guessing this is where the confectionery is manufactured. Just show you a bit better. So you can see. Then if we open it up, we have reads from top to bottom, I think. And all of the symbols. Did you look image artworks. Amazing. Then you close it up. And then on the back is, I'm guessing, manufacturer's details. I don't know. So that's the little booklet. A bag I purchased at the weekend. I went to Sonisphere, Metallica's What Headlining. So I purchased this bag. This is lots of like quirky little stools. It's got like a ribcage and this spine and then some like a pelvis. It's very unusual and it has this frilled section around it. It's a nice sized bag. It's got these long handles, and it also has an optional shoulder strap. I won't be using yet. So I won't show the inside, but I wanted to just share with you the detailing on this bag. So let's take a closer look. On the one side, we have this black on black kind of filigree design. But we have, if you look very carefully, you can see some skulls. They're not ordinary studs, so let's take a closer look. As you can see, that is a stud of a skull head. It's really cool. And these feature several sections of this bag. So as we zoom out, we can see they are here and here and here and here. Then they are along the bottom here and here, same on the other side. Now, I bought a really nice brush today. I decided to buy this because it's more gentle on your hair. Makes your hair shiny and conditions, and it doesn't pull on your hair like the plastic ones do. I managed to pick this up at TK Maxx and it was £5, and it is a brush made with boar hair bristles. Gentle on the hair. So relaxing. So soft. So relaxing. Just close your eyes. And feel how good that feels. Listen to the sound.